It is a pleasure to welcome Ido Aharoni to this program, the Consul General of Israel in New York. Mr. Ambassador, thank you for taking the time.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Your country is under attack. What do we need to do to help?
Well, I think that politically, the administration expressed a very strong support in Israel's right to defend itself. Publicly, I have to tell you, as someone who's based here in New York, I'm overwhelmed with the expressions of sympathy and support from all over, Jews and non-Jews alike.
Well, you have my support. This show has always been a supporter of Israel. We've taken this show to Israel a number of times, and I think you're in a very precarious position. You're surrounded by people who want you dead. They want your country gone. But I want to know, I understand that because you're a diplomat, you have to be diplomatic about the administration, but it doesn't seem to me that President Obama or the Obama administration has been the biggest supporter of Israel lately or at any time during the administration.
Well, I can tell you that as a government, we're extremely appreciative of the position taken by the White House, as was expressed by the White House press secretary today, that recognizes Israel's right to act in self-defense in order to protect our citizens from yet another massive onslaught launched by Hamas.
So what do you need to do? I mean, there was, I think, the admirable move by Israel to put its money where its mouth is and say, listen, we're going to pull out of Gaza unilaterally. You didn't demand anything in return for that. But ever since you did that, all you've had is, at various times, attacks, rockets fired from Gaza toward your cities. And indiscriminately, they hit whoever they happen to fall on, in some cases, Muslims who live inside your country. At what point does Israel have to say, we can't just go back and selectively, exterminate terrorists within Gaza? Is there a point where Israel has to go back into the Gaza Strip?
Well, it is certainly a possibility. The Israeli government, which is our commander-in-chief, our cabinet, will have to make a decision. I can tell you that they already authorized the Israeli Defense Forces to recruit 40,000 reservists in preparation for a massive ground operation. It doesn't mean that the ground operation will be waged, but it means that we are preparing for all eventualities.
Because at this point, I think the count is you've got 118 rocket launching sites, 6 Hamas compounds, 10 militant command centers, all of these within the Gaza Strip, which, just would you mind describing geographically what it is? I've seen it myself, but what is it, 8 or 10 miles wide and 25 miles long? It's a tiny piece of land.
Hamas controls the Gaza Strip, which is the home for 1.8 million Palestinians. We're very careful not to inflict harm on innocent people. We're trying to operate as surgically as we can, but in the last 48 hours, we attacked at least 500 sites in Gaza Strip. Most of them were tunnels through which the Hamas is smuggling most of the weapons and the ammunition. Some of them were workshops where they prepare their ammunition and weapons. Some of them were headquarters where the directives are coming out of, and so on. I can tell you that in the last 48 hours, we were challenged by 450 attempts to attack Israeli citizens, practically paralyzing our entire southern and central region, putting nearly half of Israel's population of 8.2 million people at risk.
Mr. Ambassador, it was once the case that they would shoot these rockets and they'd only go as far as Sderot, or they'd go to Beersheba, relatively close by. They've now extended their reach.
Yes, they have 12,000 rockets. They were able to amass 12,000 rockets in the last several years. Mid and long range, they have 50-mile range, they have 100-mile range. We have to understand that 100 miles puts the northern region of Israel within range at risk. And obviously, this is something that is unacceptable to us. We cannot tolerate it. No government in its right mind would tolerate it, and the Israeli government is no different.
Mr. Ambassador, are those weapons coming in through Egypt? Are they coming in from Turkey? How are they getting all these weapons, thousands and thousands of missiles, into the Strip?
Well, the origin of the weapons comes from Syria and Iran. The methodology is most of the weapons are coming through the tunnels. There are 800 active tunnels that link Sinai Peninsula with the Gaza Strip. Mm-hmm. Sinai, for our listeners to know, is under the jurisdiction of Egypt. There were several attempts in the past to smuggle arms through the Mediterranean by sea, and that's why we imposed strict policy to search every vessel, every boat, every ship that enters Gaza through the Mediterranean. We view this as a precautionary measure, an act of self-defense.
Mr. Ambassador, what would you like Americans to understand about this situation? Because it seems like every time you fight back for your own lives and the survival of your country, the world, much of the world, officially says we don't approve of what Israel is doing. What would you like Americans to understand?
The biggest misconception is that this is a territorial dispute with Hamas that we're having. There's nothing farther from the truth than this. We're actually looking at a century-old a Palestinian Arab onslaught on Jewish national sovereignty in the land of Israel. If you look at the Hamas charter, the defining document of this terrorist organization, they say there openly and explicitly that they're about two things: Islamic rule, creating an Islamic state, and the obliteration. They actually use the word obliteration of the state of Israel. They call it the Jewish
absolutely outrageous. Mr. Ambassador, it is a pleasure to have you on the program.
Thank you for having me.
I just can't thank you enough, and I can't tell you how much many of us who visited your country, who pray for your country, we want your country to survive. You are an important ally to the United States, and you certainly are a shining beacon of freedom in the middle of a really, really terrible region full of despots and terrorists and other bad guys. So thank you so much for taking the time. I know you're a busy guy, and we very much appreciate you coming on the program.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Ambassador Ido Aharoni, the Consul General of Israel in New York.